shakes Carmelo a little bit. Carmelo doesn't want to get up too close for fear that Nate will go by him. So he raises up and hits the three.
And each were teed up just a moment ago. And apparently a technical foul was called.
Conversation between Carmelo Anthony and Nate Robinson. Each were teed up just a moment ago. And apparently a technical foul was called. Was hit with the tee.
And he was starting to walk through the tall after the Tom Thibodeau stepped out and would stop, leave it alone, get back over to the bench.
Marco Bellinelli.
J.R. Smith, 77% free throw shooter. Talking about the injured big players. Marco Bellinelli
also sidelined.
Coming back. Talking about the injured Knick players, Amari Stoudemire also sidelined.
There's no way he'd be ready.
The first round of the covering for knee surgery. And
he might be able to
Mike Woodson
come back, but that's one of those.
Saying there's no way he'd be ready for the first round of the playoffs. They would hope that they
have to continue down the road.
Might be able to
channel problems to
come back, but that's one of those we shall see. As Robinson's
situation
is fouled.
Amari one,
clearly Amari was the one that was down the road.
Back. Definitely not before the regular season ends.
Tyson Chandler, one-time member of the Bulls, played 5 years here with Chicago. Remember, they had both Chandler and Eddie Curry at the same time. Chandler was the second overall pick in the draft back in 2001 out of high school, taken by the Clippers and then traded to the Bulls.
Remember everybody talking about the Bulls having these two young big men that were going to be there for so many years down the road. Interesting how the careers have taken different paths.
That was shortly after the Michael Jordan, Steve Kerr era.
Steve Kerr, yes.
Coming up on a minute remaining in this first half. Nick swinging. Smith backs it up on Robinson. Here's J.R. Smith. Hamilton set up by Heinrich. Butler kept it alive and then handled by Smith. Smith to the rim. Butler shaken up and remained in the front court. As a result, it was a 5-on-4.
Hit in the face as he went back to the other end to try and get that offensive rebound.
The Knicks up by 5. They jumped in front early, 23-6, reeled off 14 unanswered at one stretch. Robinson called for a timing violation. Joey Crawford with the call. I see Robinson staring in that direction and then quickly turned back the other way.
That's why you have to learn as a player. That guy's got the whistle in his mouth. You give him something he doesn't want to hear early in the game. He hits you with a tee. He's watching you for the rest of the game.
Here's Felton. Off the dribble, he beats Heinrich. Nice move by Raymond Felton.
When you have five smalls on the floor, Chicago does, that are not used to playing team defense with each other, that's the kind of breakdown that you can have. You're thinking that big man's there to protect, and he's not there.
Foul committed by Felton. Both teams are over the limit. So Robinson, 78% free throw shooter. Go to the line. Down to 25 seconds remaining in this first half. Robinson with his 13th point. And now Malcolm Thomas, a recent addition to the Bulls squad. Out of San Diego State, spent some time with San Antonio, Golden State, the D-League. He's played in Israel and Korea. This is a fourth game as a member of Chicago.
And Rip Hamilton, who gave Chicago good minutes, 4-7 from the floor, has two personal fouls, so Thibodeau taking him out now so he doesn't pick up another one with 25 seconds remaining.
Thomas, 6'9", 225 pounds. They're looking for another big man off the bench. Robinson with all 14 of his points here in the second quarter. About a second differential between the game clock and shot clock as this first half comes to a close. Here's Novak for three. Rebounded by Teague, who just came on. And that is the end of the first half. A lot of points given up by a Chicago team that allows only 92 points a game. The Knicks lead at 59-54. Carmelo Anthony, 16 points. J.R. Smith with 14. A quick break coming up, and then on to Atlanta for the sprint halftime with Ernie, Kenny, Charles, and Shaq.